Very good morning to all of you. Today we are starting with the third unit of computer graphics. Third unit basically consists of three parts. First one is the two-dimensional transformation, second one is the three-dimensional transformation, and finally the projection. Today we will start with the two-dimensional transformation. So these are the contents. Basically, what is a transformation, why transformations are needed, a quick recap of the basic matrix mathematics, then there are four types of transformation we'll be studying: translation, scaling, rotation, and sharing. Finally, the homogeneous coordinates and how to combine multiple transformations one after another. Okay, so let us begin with the definition of transformation. Basically, transform means to change something, right? So what is a transformation? Transformation is a geometrical change of an object from the current state to a modified state. So to change the state of the object, one or more from the following should be changed. What can be changed? Firstly, the position can be changed. That means I can shift the object from one point to another point. And this type of transformation is known as translation. Second one is the change of size. That means either I am making it larger or making the object smaller. And this change is called scaling. Third one is the change in orientation or change in angle, that is the rotation. And finally, the fourth one which we will be studying, that is change in shape or applying pressure to the particular object, that is known as the shear transformation. Okay, so if I want my object to be translated as well as scaled, I have to apply both these type of transformations. And for combining these multiple transformation, we need a similar type of approach, right? So we will be performing a sequence of matrix multiplication to the object vertices. Okay. And that way we will finally get the transformed object. So before going into the details, let us just have a look about why the transformations are needed. Hope you all remember the two-dimensional viewing transformation from the second unit. Right, we were modeling a particular object using the modeling coordinate. Then we were placing that object in the world coordinate system, that is called our window. Now we were selecting a particular portion from that window and we were showing that particular portion to the viewport or the display device, right? So that is the need of the transformation. In real life also, we often rearrange objects or look at them from different angles. For example, I want to share a photo with my friend, so I may need to rotate it, may need to crop it, something like that, right? So graphic systems, they should also have the same facility so that we can manipulate the initially created object and we can display the modified object without having to remodel it and redraw it. Okay, if transformation is not there, then suppose I'm using a single object multiple times, we have to show it in the viewport. Suppose a ball is thrown. So the ball will follow a particular path, and when the ball will go far away from us, the size of the ball will be smaller as well, right? So if transformation is not there for all these positions, maybe 100 positions of ball will be there. So for each position, we have to model it using the modeling coordinate. then placing in the window, and then performing the viewing transformation and show it in the display device. So transformation mathematics, it reduces our task. We need not perform, model it multiple times. Once the modeling is done, I will be applying the transformation and reproduce it. Okay. So even we are not performing two-dimensional viewing transformation multiple times. That is the need of the transformation. Let us just have a quick recap of this example. Suppose I want to draw this part multiple times in this drawing, in this image. So I have placed it here. Also, I have placed it here. Okay. Now, let us have details on this one. So this one is smaller, the original object which I have drawn using the modeling coordinate system. And this object in the world coordinate system, that is bigger. So I have changed the size of the object. That means I have scaled the object. Okay, that is one point. Next one is, this is almost near to the y value 0, right? Here. But here, if I consider this as the coordinate, so this is far away. That means I have to translate it as well. Okay. So to get this image from this one, I have applied two different transformations. One is scaling, another one is translation. Okay. Similarly, for this object, I have scaled it because the size is changed. I have to translate it, obviously. But before that, what have I done? I have also rotated it. This was horizontal and this is vertical. So I have rotated it by 90 degrees. Then I have performed the translation. So here, a series of transformations, that means scaling, rotation and translation, have been performed. Okay. So for mathematical representation, we need a special kind of applications where the representation or the organization of the data is convenient. So that is why we use matrix, because the matrix processing, that is also efficient. And you know that computer graphics operations are quite heavy. We need much operations. So those operations which are efficient, we have to use them more. That is why we have chosen the matrix method. And not only that, matrix method, it also enables us with the combination of various concatenation of different type of transformations. Suppose I want to perform translation, scaling, translation, or translation, rotation, scaling, whatever be. So if I can perform the matrix multiplication beforehand, it would be easier to calculate. That is why we are using the matrix. Okay. So there will be basically three types of matrices. First one is the object matrix or the original matrix. Second one is the transformation matrix. So that transformation matrix will be different for translation, rotation, scaling, or shear. Okay. And then we will be getting the final matrix or the matrix of the transformed object. If the matrix of the transformed object is P dashed, we will be getting it either by P cross T, P, the original matrix, multiplied by T, the transformation matrix, or we can get it like P dashed equals to T into P. So these matrix, order of the matrix multiplication, that we will see later. Okay, how to perform that. And obviously you know that P dashed T is not equals to T dashed, P multiplied by T is not equals to, may not be equal to T multiplied by P, right? Because what is the basic rule of matrix multiplication? The number of columns in the first matrix that should be equivalent to the equal to the number of rows in the second matrix. So if I am having first matrix as m cross n and second matrix equals to n by p, then the multiplied matrix, the resultant matrix, will be having the dimension m by p. I'll just go through the matrix multiplication once if you don't remember it, but I'm confident that you know these things. Okay. Second one is the identity matrix. What is it? It is a square matrix where all diagonal elements are having the value 1 and all other elements are having the value 0. So if any matrix A is multiplied by identity matrix I, result will be A itself. Right, so that is the speciality of the identity matrix. We will be using it frequently in the transformations. Okay. How will we represent a particular point in matrix form? We are studying the two-dimensional coordinate system, right? So any point having the coordinate values px and py, it's always represented in terms of x and y coordinates, right? So the point px, py, that can be converted into matrix or in a vector in the following two ways. One is the row measure matrix, where I am writing this way, p or the original point equals to px, py. Or it can be written in a column measure matrix. That means p equals to px, py. That means two rows and one columns, 2x1 matrix, and the row measure matrix is one row and two columns. That means 1 by 2. Dimension of row measure matrix is 1 by 2, and the dimension of column measure matrix is 2x1. These representation, this P, they are often called as the position vectors. Okay. Okay. Transformation convention. Okay. So as we were discussing it earlier, that P multiplied by T may not be equal to T multiplied by P, depending upon the dimension, right? So two conventions are used to represent data and perform the transformations. One is the post-multiplication transformation, and second one is the pre-multiplication transformation. So if the position vector or the point is represented as a row matrix, okay, in that case, the post multiplication is performed. That means P dashed, how will I get it? P multiplied by T or the transformation matrix. Okay. And if it is the other way around, if the position vector is represented as column matrix, then the pre-multiplication with the inverse transformation matrix is needed. That means I will get the P dashed equals to T inverse into P. So that's all about the basic idea of transformation. In the next video, we will be checking how the translation will be, how the actual transformations are being performed. So there are basically 5 types of geometric transformations: translation or the change in position, scaling or the change in size, rotation or the change in orientation, shear or the change in the shape of the object, and finally the reflection, that is reflecting it with respect to a particular axis, but the reflection is not there in the syllabus. That's all about my first video. Okay, thank you.